During my nearly 8 months of world travel, I spent 2.5 weeks in Turkey. I was very surprised by just how much Turkey has to offer. Due to the exchange rate against strong currency, it is an affordable destination. I enjoyed visiting the big city, unique natural settings, the beach, and ancient ruins. Overall, I made it to 6 destinations and spent time visiting friends. This video will help you decide where to take your own trip. With a detailed plan and some hustle, you can even cover most of this itinerary in 1 week. To learn more details and get a better feel for a particular place, pick out the individual location videos from my Turkey playlist. The beginning of any trip to Turkey is the historic city of Istanbul, a massive sprawling city that has swallowed up the space of 20 million people. Stay near the Eminönü district, either side of the Bosporus is fine. Taking the ferries across and enjoying the waterfront views for the price of a metro fare was actually one of my favorite things to do. In the Eminönü district, you will see the Hagia Sophia, a wonder of the world, close to it, the Blue Mosque, and the Spice Bazaar and the Grand Bazaar. While walking in this region, you will be approached by very helpful, friendly people who will follow you around to talk with you. They always end up trying to sell you something. After being in the Balkans, where service was indifferent, Turkey was a pleasant contrast. Whether they are trying to sell you something or you are in a restaurant, the service will come with effort, friendliness, and will be very prompt. Coming from a different context, it can come across as pretty aggressive salesmanship and may wear on you by the end of the trip. From Istanbul, I took a flight down to Izmir, rented a car, and drove to Ephesus. When renting a car, check the prices and paperwork carefully. Fox Rent-A-Car billed me the $30 insurance fee, even though I opted out of it. The ruins of Ephesus include the spectacular 25,000-seat theater, the beautifully restored facade of the Library of Celsus, a covered archaeological dig open to the public, and many pillars and engraved stones. It is a place where you can walk the streets of history. From there, it is a 2.5-hour drive to Pamukkale. Though not as spectacular as it once was, thanks to water mismanagement, the site has gone through some restoration and you can still see turquoise water in shallow pools. The minerals in the spring water builds up deposits of travertine, creating an otherworldly landscape of pools cascading down the hillside. To prevent damage, everyone is required to go barefoot. Be careful, it's very slippery in some places. There are also some Roman ruins to check out on the hilltop. My next destination was Fethiye, a coastal city with what I thought would be interesting hillside carved tombs. Those turned out to be small and covered in graffiti and do not make the city a destination. Instead, you can enjoy beaches, islands, hang gliding, and caverns in the surrounding region. For me, I took a few days and relaxed by the beach. I finished out my relaxing beach week to the north at Marmaris, a resort town. I was there out of season and enjoyed having the place to myself extra cheap. My final destination and absolute highlight was Gorme, in the region better known as Cappadocia. The otherworldly landscape was created out of soft volcanic rock that has been carved by the elements over time. For centuries, people have lived here in the underground cities carved into the soft rock. A tour going into cities like Derinköy are an absolute must. The Selime Monastery is an above-ground location with rooms carved into rocks. It is an incredible place to see. The region is also known for its hot air balloon rides. As a low-budget, around-the-world traveler, I was not sure about expending my travel budget. Fortunately, I met a woman who had ridden hot air balloons on several continents, and she assured me this was the best in the world. Wow, was she right. It was an amazing experience and the top highlight of my entire around-the-world trip. I was there in November in the off-season, and was able to book a ticket through my hostel for 770 lira, just under $140. Absolutely worth it. Check out my Turkey playlist for videos showing more of each of these destinations. If you know you'll never come ride the balloons here yourself, you can watch a longer video of my balloon ride from launch to landing. Thanks for watching my channel, Journeyman Dan. Please subscribe and like below.